morning. This is my 8th concert in Help Library, and about the same subject, music therapy. This instrument is called as sarod, and which is not very famous, popular like sitar. But it's a unique instrument, and I've been playing it for last 27 years. So this is actually therapy is basically for stress. And I have a background of pharmaceutical industry. We are into manufacturing of Ayurvedic products. So after coming from Singapore, I stayed in Singapore for 6 months in 2000. And we came to know that people from abroad, this globe, they used to admire Indian music. And it was a very interesting part of us that they used to tell us that Indian music is very soothing. And that was a registration actually, that I should do something. I came to Mumbai and I started speaking to my colleagues who are physicians, and slowly one put me to Dean of KM Hospital, and from where actually the journey started. Being a musician, it's very difficult for him to go to hospital unless you have that passion or some background. And in Sion Hospital, Department of Psychiatry, we could done the experiment with 6 concerts. And it was the afternoon time, so there were a few patients. Once patients leave the campus, they don't come back again. So that was a problem. But in the meantime, there was this Indian Psychiatric Society conference 3 days in Renaissance. And I met some 3,000 psychiatrists all over India. Like, they could understand what I'm doing. And then we immediately started with Thana Mental Hospital concert. With, I think that was a story of 2006. And I gave 6 concerts. Then medical student changed, and the program got stuck. We have again restarted on 4th of Jan. Again I started. Then I gave a concert in Pune also. So what I want to tell you is, this is not only theory, but I have done practical. I have given 8 concerts in autistic school in our hospital. And I could find that autistic child is invariably very hyper. It's very difficult for him to make seat at one place. And out of 10, 7 were responding like an adult. And it was an amazing sight. ZTV News came and they made a shooting. NDTV came. So what I mean to say is, this is myself, you can call me, musician is always selfish to play anywhere, either it is temple, music circle, corporate, anywhere. My intention is to promote our culture, and which people are forgetting. When I gave concerts in Union Bank, 3 concerts, the general manager said, my officers need your therapy. We have forgotten that we have this rich culture heritage. And I could explain that we have morning ragas, afternoon, we have sunset ragas, evening, late night. So Saregama Padhanisa, these are 7 notes and 7 chakras, they are matching. So the whole world music is based on these 7 notes. But this is the only music, Indian music, which has a time bound law. Like morning, like we change our mood after every prahar 3 hours. These rag raginis are designed according to a biological clock. So this is the only act, a rule you'll find only in Indian classical music. Not even Karnataka music. If you go to Chennai, they invariably sing any rag at any time. So this is applicable to a body. It calms your nerves. It secretes enzymes, hormones. Means I would call it, it will restore. If it is more, it will make less. If it is less, it will stabilize. So that's a very important part. And these vibrations, they penetrate the right part of the brain, left both, but right part is a brain for creativity. And it will stimulate that part. It will ignite. So this is a very interesting and very deep science, which nobody has entered into this. I am the only person who is entering now, and I am thankful to media that for last 4 years they had given so many articles on me. My CD is also launched. Science of Music is the name of the CD, and it's the two CDs, one for morning, like, and sunrise, sunset, post sunset. So this is the basic idea of promoting our culture, whether it is harmonium, sitar, anything. Notes are notes. The difference is only every instrument has got a limitation. But I would say instrumental is better because it has a universal language. If you say folk or any vocal song, there is a problem that American person cannot understand what you sing. And instrumental is, it's universal. The depth is important. Clarity of notes are important. And this is basically a male instrument. This is a leather. It's a lamb leather. And this is a wooden body. This is a showpiece, but there's a connection inside which will give you resonance also. There are 4, 4, 8 and 2, 10 and 15 strings. According to ragas, you can adjust. These are the small holes. These wires have gone from down here. And this is what I'm playing with. It's not acrylic. It's a coconut shell. So, hard. But wires are very soft. We use plain coconut oil just for lubrication and fast movement. We have to play with skin and the tip of the nail, which will give you a sharpness of the note. There are no frets like sitar. And there is no bow like violin. So continuity is not maintained in this. It's a very difficult task. So it all depends upon the quality of the leather here. This is the electronic tanpura, and we call it as the basic keynote, which is sa, or you can call it as om. Om. This is basic 220 hertz. This physics what I'm talking is, and as you increase the note, it's 240, 260, 280 like. This sa will correspond to muladhara chakra, that is root. And sa re ga ma, chest is ma, is heart, anagat chakra. This is throat, pa here, and sixth sense, third eye, that is dha, and crown is knee. Like this is an arrangement. This is a basic of yoga. It can be a hypothesis, unless you prove it, it is a hypothesis. In European countries, they do a lot of exercises on music therapy. They have high-tech instruments. They do what not, brain scan and functional MRI and many things. But simple experiment can be done here also. We can make two groups, one with plain medication, conventional medicine, and one with music added. Third group, again, have only music also. It's comparatively. And in probably we might start on studies assignments.